Dozil, welcome back to my channel. Today's video, class Magnet Merrily ECM. In this video, we will discuss about flow side of injector sections, which are commonly get faulty, and this ECM's very common problem. So now I am explaining each and everything about this low side of injector section. Then I will explain all high sides injector section. As you see here, I have drawn all and teach you step by step. So please do like, share and subscribe to my channel if you get knowledge from this video. So this is the low side of injector, this 1 2 3 4 MOSFET is a low side of injector sections, and this is the injector IC, and its three is the actuating IC, injector MOSFET actuating IC. It is not an injector IC, it's a injector MOSFET actuating IC. These two are 12 voltage actuating MOSFET switching IC. This is the 21 voltage high voltage switching IC, switching MOSFET IC. Okay, now I'm going to explain all the things about the injector sections. So if I make some mistake, please comment me and guide me, then I will improve myself. Okay, and here is a as you see, I draw the diagram same as ECM. Here is a 1 2 3 4. These four are n channel MOSFET, 1 2 3. These four are n channel MOSFETs, and these four are high channel. This also no channel MOSFET, but using high side injector sections. Okay, and this is using for low side injector section. Low side injector section means ground switching. Here ground, any injectors have two terminals, one is negative and another is positive. So when injector needs negative voltage, on that time we call it low side of injector section. It means it's switching ground and injectors getting ground voltage. Okay, and high side means injector getting positive voltage. That's why we called high side of injector section. Okay, here is a 4 n channel MOSFET. Here is a resistance 201. It means 200 ohm resistance. Here is the 0 ohm resistance, 1 2 3. Here is the 1 2 3 4 diode. These diodes are used for protections. These diodes are used for protection. I will explain further how it protect our circuit. Okay, and this is the injector MOSFET switching actuating IC. Okay, you can say switching or actuating, both are same. So you can also say injector number 1, injector 2, injector 3 are injector IC. Commonly people know injector IC, but it is not a actuating switching IC, MOSFET switching IC, injector MOSFET switching IC. We call it injector MOSFET switching IC. Okay, and how it's work, let's I'm going to explain. Here is a, this is the source. This is the n channel MOSFET one have gate. This is the gate of MOSFET, and this is the source of MOSFET, and this is the drain. These drains attach to this pin, and this pin goes to injectors through coupler and wiring. Okay, so when we need switching, here is the injectors and this is the low side. We need here ground voltage. On that time, this ground attached to here, this drain, this MOSFET drain attached to injectors pin number 1. It means injector, one pin of injectors. Okay, when this gate getting command from injector IC pin number 15, when this IC commanding pin number 15 to this MOSFET gate, on that time this source are always connected to ground. On that time when this gate get pulse, positive pulse from this IC, on that time this source ground out from drain to injectors. It's not continuously out. It work like a duty cycle. Who decided to switching this processor? This processor decided when switching the injectors, on that time this processor command to this IC, and this IC command to this MOSFET out ground for injectors. Okay, same as it is, all injectors as work, all MOSFET source connect to the ground here, all connect to the ground, and all drain connected to injector number 1, 2, 3, and 4, and this all MOSFET get connect to this two IC. When this IC command one by one to the MOSFET required for inch. Okay, so why question is there? One question is creating you all your mind. So why this diode are used? 1, 2, 3, and 4. Four diode. Why four diode use? So if here is a injectors, here is the injectors. This is the injectors, and this is the low side, and this is the high side. High side means 21 voltage. It's getting 21 voltage. If these pins attach short to each other, if this pin short to each other, on that time this MOSFET get faulty. So this MOSFET burn out. So it's unable to burn. That's why I use this diode. When this voltage, positive voltage, when here gets short 21 voltage to the low side of injector section, on that time this voltage travel from here to here, but it will not damage this MOSFET, and this goes to here diode, and it's connect to the 21 voltage. So circuit will complete and it will not damage the circuit. This is the very, very, very important for the protection. That's why we call these diodes are used for protections. Okay, and here processor always needs which injectors are working or not working. If not working, he appears the fault code. If not appears the fault code, it means there is the faulty in software and hardware. So that's why we use the feedback. If this feedback will not present, it will not working properly, it's created fault P0201, P0202, P0203, P0204, P0205, any if you have a 6-cylinder engine, P0606. This is the common fault code of injector section, low side of injector section. Have a low side, on that time this fault code will appear. If you have a problem in high side, this voltage is not appear. Okay, this fault code is not appear. When this MOSFET get command from this IC, on that time this ground out for the injector, ground here source ground out for the injector from drain, on that time this ground also pass through these two resistance to this injector IC. Here you can see. So all 1, 2, 3, 4 N channel MOSFET drain also connected to this four resistance for feedback. So as you see here, if the injector number one is working on the tamp, it will out ground for injector, and also here go and take the feedback, this ICC MP560. Also injector number 2, injector number 3 same, injector number 4 same, injector number 5, injector number 2 same. So this is the feedback section. That's why we call the feedback. This is a very important and commonly get faulty. Okay, and now I will trace out how to trace the ECM. Here you can see these all sources are common. As you see, I will zoom the video and show you all sources are common. Here is a multimeter. Set the multimeter to continuity here, and if you touch the both positive both terminal, it will sound, and here you can see here zero. So you can see this four n channel MOSFET source connect to each other. You can see here zero is showing, and also zero, and also here is a zero. It means four source are ground and it connected each other. And also here is a drain. So you can see here this will be connect to here, as you see, and this drain also feedback for here, and this drain connected to the feedback of this transistor, and also this drain connected to the feedback of this resistance. Same as it is, like that you can trace via this pin. If suppose you get injector number one is faulty, injector number one is not working, your fault code appears P0201 on the tam, you trace the wire low side of injector section. If P0201 on the tam, you trace the wire to this pin, from injector to this pin, and after that you trace here, and then you trace here and check the MOSFET. Is the n-channel MOSFET. It means I'm not showing the exit diagram, but you normally get how to get an easy understanding, easy understanding. Here you can see I'm drawing a simple to for better understanding. Here is a suppose you have this, here is also guys, this is the diode. It means when you put here negative terminals and multimeter, you put the multimeter of negative terminals here and positive terminals here, it will not showing any reading. I will show you here, and this is the, I am putting this negative terminal of this MOSFET and source and get, as you see, this reading. Why showing? Because these all are integrated, that's why some reading are showing. Okay, and it is not showing continuously. If I put here negative on the time, this positive goes to here. As you see, here is a negative. I put the drain the multimeter negative terminals and source positive terminals, as you see showing 571. As it is same, all are showing 570. It means all diodes, all MOSFETs are okay. All MOSFET. If some getting out voltage, it means it is the fault. I hope you get this point. You get how to check a MOSFET. Okay. And no any pins beep sound. No beep sound should coming to any both pin, two pin. Okay, as you see. No sound should be there. Okay? No reading should be there. So this is the very simple and to test MOSFET, how to test the MOSFET. And I will make video in detail about the on MOSFETs and alls. So guys, if you get the knowledge from this video, please do like, share and subscribe to my channel. So thank you. Thanks for watching.